Hi dear students, I am Anuj Sir. We are here with Kushal Lodha. He scored All India 5th rank in November 2019 exams. So we welcome over here. I hope that all the students who are going to be giving their CA final, CA inter as well as their CA foundation will learn a lot of things from Kushal. So welcome Kushal.
Thank you so much sir.
Thank you. And Kushal, we'll start away by asking few questions. Okay, first of all, obviously the result came. How did you feel on the first day when the result had come?
So to be very frank, I was extremely overwhelmed. So first I checked my score. So it was a total of 566. So I was under the impression that I would secure a double digit rank because last year my friend had scored 566.
Okay.
And he was an All India rank 13. But then fortunately I checked the merit list and I found that I had secured an All India rank 5. So
okay,
that was the moment when I was brimming with joy. And that was the moment like when I was on the seventh heaven. So I couldn't believe that I have secured an AIR 5 in my CA finals. My parents were into tears. Like that feeling, to be honest, cannot be expressed in words. It can only be felt.
Kushal, in IPCC also you had a rank, right?
Yes, in IPCC also I had a rank.
Rank so, number?
Initially it was rank number 10 when my IPCC results were announced. But then I had put my papers into revaluation because I had scored 62 in accounting, whereas I was expecting 80 plus in accounts.
Okay.
So fortunately, after 5 months, I had got a call from ICI saying that congratulations, dear student, your rank has been upgraded from 10 to 5 as 16 marks in accounts had been increased. So in IPCC also, I had secured an AIR 5 and in CA finals also, I have retained that position.
That's so nice. So guys, one small thing, if you're sure that you have done good, you can please give your marks for revaluation. Things might become better. Okay, Kushal, we'll go over to the next thing. Few questions that I would like to ask. First of all, you had joined us in which year?
I had joined AJ Next in the year August 2017.
In RBG Hostel itself?
Yes, in RBG Hostel itself.
So how did you come to know about us?
So when I was into first year of my articleship, I asked my seniors like which class to join and which are the good classes in Mumbai. So they recommended me AJ Next. So only one reason for joining AJ Next was that conceptual clarity was being delivered to the students. Like just like a base is important for a building to get constructed, concepts are must for a CA student in order to apply them in the examination. And that was the thing I was looking for in Mumbai. So that was the main reason that I joined AJ Next. And since my seniors recommended me, I thought that even I should try this option.
Okay, so then let me just ask you, I think costing we did there, we did tax there. Okay, so at least about these particular two subjects. So how was costing? Although I taught it, I should not be asking actually. Okay, but how was costing?
So costing was very, very nice. Like you taught the subject like very well and all the concepts were clarified, all the doubts were clarified. Like I was feeling as if I was getting a personal attention since I had to get down 3 floors only. So it was an RBG hostel itself. So it was as if a professor is coming to your home to teach you. And since the batch was of a smaller size, I was getting personal attention also. And that was the thing which I loved about costing.
Okay. And tax about RS sir?
Yeah, RS sir was also very nice. He was very energetic while teaching and he used to motivate all the students in between. So that was the thing which I loved about him. And he used to teach with so much of energy that he used to ensure nobody in the class is sleeping. So that was the thing which I loved about him. And in the last day also, he had shared some motivational stories of himself and him scoring exemptions in all the subjects. So that helped us a lot. And that was very inspiring for the students to score better marks in the examination.
So that's so nice, yeah. In any case, when RSR speaks, his voice is too loud. I don't think so. So anybody in hostel can sleep here when he's taking the lectures.
Yeah, true.
So, let me ask you one thing I think that most of the students would like me to ask. So, what was your strategy for the exams? And we'll go a bit stepwise. Like, you know, that did you complete all your tuitions, say, around 4 to 5 months before?
Yes. Like, I had completed all the classes of 8 subjects in April 2019 itself. So,
that was too early.
Yeah, so I had gone to my study leave from 15th of June 2019.
Okay.
So I had finished off with all my classes before the examination leave.
So you got ample leave, right?
Yeah, I had got a leave of 4.5 months.
4.5 months. Okay, so that's good, I guess. And I guess 4.5 months is an apt time for you. 4 to 4.5 months if you get, I think it is enough for whatever studies you have to be doing. So you belong to Nasik, right?
Yes, I'm from Nasik.
Okay, so How did you land up in Mumbai?
So basically, like, I had secured a rank in my intermediate examination also, IPCC. So I wanted an overall exposure in taxation, in audit, in finance. So I wanted a firm wherein I can get overall exposure. And since Mumbai is the financial capital of India, I thought that going to Mumbai would be the best option. And traveling between Mumbai and Nasik is also convenient. It's only about 3 hours.
Okay.
So that was the main reason I shifted to Mumbai. And in frankly speaking, in Nasik, there are not so good opportunities as compared to Mumbai. So yeah, that was the main reason of me shifting to Mumbai.
An articleship, it matters a lot, right?
Yes, it matters a lot as far as your future is concerned.
Sure. So guys, one thing that you should be taking your articleship quite seriously, that is something that helps you actually, not only for future, but also it'll help you in exams. So many things like audit, like tax, you automatically come to know if you're trying to do them in day-to-day life. Kushal, you know, everybody, when they are doing CA, they have some kind of a motivation, you know, or some kind of an ideal person to look upon to. So who was yours?
Like, to be very honest, like, I used to look upon my dad only. So he was also doing CA, but unfortunately he couldn't clear CA because of his fortune or because of any other reason. So it was my dream that I become a chartered accountant so that his dream gets fulfilled. So that was the main source of motivation. So whenever I used to get frustrated out of studying, or whenever I used to get bored of studying, I used to think that I have to make my parents proud. So that was the only source of motivation, because the happiness and the feeling which you will get when those two letters of C and A will get added to your name would be much more than the happiness in the short-term enjoyments of going out and hanging out with friends.
Correct.
So I had also read a very good quote on Instagram saying that if you don't sacrifice for what you want, then what you want becomes the sacrifice. So if you don't sacrifice outings and going out with friends for becoming a CA, maybe you'll have to sacrifice the degree of CA one day.
Correct.
So that was the thing which I had inculcated into my mind. And going forward, like moving forward with that particular optimism, I had no chance wherein I was frustrated and I was bored. So that was the only source of motivation.
That's so good. You have made your dad proud.
Yes.
So Kushal, let's continue with the strategy of trying to prepare for exams. So you got 4.5 months leave. That was one thing. So how did you plan your 4.5 months?
So to be honest, like, I got a 4.5 months leave, but then my real sister's wedding was there in July. So I had like 15 days I had to give over there only. So I had only 4 months in my hand.
Okay.
So in the 4 months, I had planned that I'll finish off with my group one first. Then
okay,
I'll finish off with my group two. So in the span of 3 months, I had finished off with my first reading of group one subjects and group two subjects.
Okay.
So till 30th September, I had finished off with first reading of all 8 subjects.
Okay.
And in the last month of October, I used to study 4 days per subject.
Okay.
4 to 5 days per subject. So I used to memorize things in the last month, and I used to study as well as like memorize in those last month. That was very useful for me to write answers in the examination because it was nearer to my exam. So what my strategy was that I used to study in slots of 2 hours, and there were 6 slots I used to study daily. So
okay,
a total of 12 hours.
Okay.
And most importantly is that in a span of 12 hours, apart from 12 hours, like I used to go to jogging track daily for 15 to 20 minutes. So that is also
good.
Very important.
Yeah.
Like staying in touch with a particular hobby is very important. So if you like to play cricket, go play cricket. If you like to love to listen music for for half an hour or for 15 to 20 minutes, that will refresh your mind and that will rejuvenate your body completely. So that is also a very important thing which I think all the CA students should take care of. And like while studying, the attitude was that I used to sit and the books were there. Books were the only thing which existed in this world. Like,
okay,
this will sound nerdy, of course, but then it's the bitter truth. You should study with 100% efficiency and effectiveness, and then and only then you will be able to get a like rank or get a good result.
Sure.
So according to me, like, effective study is more important than studying for longer hours. Studying for 8 hours in a day effectively is much better than studying for 12 hours with 4 hours of distraction.
Obviously.
So I believe in effective study. So therefore, I had switched off my mobile phone for 4 months.
Okay.
So I was off social media. I was literally grounded for 4 months.
Okay.
And I had to sacrifice upon many things. And thereafter, like after all the sacrifices, when I saw my result, I was like, all the sacrifices which I've done, they were worth it.
Sure.
So that was my main strategy.
Your results are excellent, actually. They speak for themselves. So what do you plan to do after this?
After this, I would mostly apply in the big three consulting firm, like BCG, McKinsey or Bain Capital. Or I'll mostly go into finance side. So
okay,
since my interest is inclined towards finance, I'd mostly go towards finance side. And after a couple of years, I am planning to do my MBA also. So mostly okay. It would be from IIM or it would be from USA. That I'll have to decide upon my CAT and GMAT score.
Okay, next question. How do you complete paper in 3 hours?
Okay, so like what my strategy was that I used to take a stopwatch with me in my examination, like digital watch.
Okay.
So I used to allocate each mark with the time. So for example, if there's a question of 4 marks, so you have to solve that question in 7.2 minutes. That is 4 okay. upon 100 into 180. So if, for example, I take 10 minutes in that particular question, then I have to ensure that the second question, I have to take 3 minutes lesser time because I've already exceeded my time limit. So okay. that was my main strategy. And because of this only, I was able to complete all my papers.
Okay.
And one more thing, as far as the paper is concerned, during the first 15 minutes, like I used to read question 2 to question 6, wherein I okay. have to decide which questions I have to attempt.
Correct.
And I used to rank them in priority, which question is best and which question I can gain maximum marks in.
Okay.
And that was the first question which I used to attempt in the examination.
Okay.
And even if you are not able to attempt any question, or if you feel in the 15 minutes that this paper is very difficult or this question is very difficult, don't panic at all. Like with the flow, you will be able to solve the entire paper very easily. It's just your confidence and your determination which is going to matter. Like your attitude should be, you have studied for 4 months, 12 hours a day. So these many hours and these many days you have already burnt out. Why are you giving up in those 3 hours? You have to write something and you have to attempt the paper entirely. That was my attitude. So this was my main strategy of completing the paper.
So you have to attempt entire 100 marks if you can, obviously.
Yes.
So did you give any mock papers or something? Did you practice any papers?
Yeah, I had given a mock series. So I had given one mock series.
Okay. I think that is something that helps a student a lot to know, like, you know, that whether you are thorough with the subjects or your speed is good.
Yes, definitely, definitely. Because if you go directly to the paper and write it for the first time, you are going to lose track on time, as well as you will not be able to attempt it as per the efficiency and effectiveness which you might have planned. So giving a mock is very important before the examination, so that you are aware that you have to solve the paper in an efficient as well as effective way. So that would be very helpful according to me.
Thank you, Kushal, for enlightening the students, like, you know, what was your strategy and so on. We wish you all the best from our side for the future. Thank you, Kushal.
Thank you. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you so much. Bye.